If I told you about a nascent empire back in 100 AC, spread over 4 million kilometers squared, governing a population of around 50 million people, and which its power and influence in the world reached a scale never before seen in human history, you would already have a name in mind and be quite sure you know who I'm going to talk about. But depending on which place in the world you're from, your answer could be completely different. All of the stats I just mentioned can be applied to two major states in power at the time, the Roman Empire and the Han Dynasty. But what if I told you that although their immense size and influence in their respective regions, they barely knew about each other? Both the Roman Empire to the west and the Han Dynasty to the east were aware of each other's existence and both knew that the other was a great empire. But their only source of information was the long and dangerous Silk Road and the merchants who dared to travel on it. By the way, I don't know if you noticed, but we are almost reaching 1000 subs on the channel, please help us reach this goal. Now back to the video. To give you some context, the Silk Road was a living hell to cross. Not only did merchants have to survive its hot sand dunes in the desert, steep mountains and brutal winds, but also thieves and venomous snakes that would lurk in the shadows waiting for an opportunity. This gave rise to a host of middlemen and trading posts along the way, where people there would survive by taxing the travelers and keeping secrets about the region so their jobs wouldn't get replaced. And so you can start to understand why the information was so hard to come by. But this doesn't mean there wasn't any trading between the two. In fact, the Romans knew the Eastern Empire by the name of Serica, meaning silk in the Roman language, due to the fact that they imported this luxurious material from this almost unknown nation. The Han Dynasty, on the other hand, didn't import many things from the then known Dachin, meaning Great China. This alludes to the fact that the Roman Empire wasn't very interested in recognizing a possible rival and thought of them as they thought about any other civilization that crossed their path, utterly inferior. The Asian ruler at the time was the first to seek information about the unknown world on the other side of the Himalayas. He ordered an expedition in 138 BC, commanded by a trustworthy messenger, Zhen Qian, who then returned with detailed reports of sophisticated civilizations to the west a full decade after the departure. These being the first statements declaring the existence of another empire forming on the other side of the world, naturally raised the interest of the emperor, who later sent multiple envoys and even armies to the region in the efforts of making contact. Although these efforts only managed to reach modern-day Iran, they helped establish new trade routes and relationships with Middle Eastern civilizations who knew much more about the rising empire in the Mediterranean. With the expanded access, new products and information started being exchanged between the neighboring civilizations, such is the case with livestock, leather, tools, religion beliefs, language, culture, philosophy and science, improving the lives of everyone in the province. One notable expedition from the Han Dynasty happened in 100 BC, where an envoy managed to reach Anshi in the Parthian Empire and was greeted by 20,000 Norsemen. The meeting went quite well, with both parties setting up new diplomatic relationships, but it is said that the Parthian Empire didn't want to lose trading perks with its new friends and advised the expedition to not go any further, claiming it would be too dangerous to venture towards the west where the Roman Empire was just starting to expand. Within the next century, the rumors turned out to be quite true, with the Roman expanding its sphere of influence much closer to the Asian nations and hearing whispers of this great empire from the east. When 97 AD came around, an Eastern general was commanded to venture further west once and for all, to make contact with the other great China. But the same happened as it did one century prior, but this time, the civilization living in modern-day Iran were the Persians, which although they gave a lot of information about the known world to the general, explaining how the empires in the region worked, how politics was practiced with 36 men gathering every week, and that no ruler was permanent, they again discouraged the two empires to meet, afraid that this would diminish their power of being the middleman between them. According to books written at the time, it can be noted that the Persians passed on to the Chinese that the Romans already had postal services in their vast empire with nearly 6,000 kilometers in length and 400 walled cities. There are even letters dating back to the period of Han Dynasty that mention a meeting held with a Roman messenger which managed to travel all the way from Europe. This traveler apparently went from South Europe through the south of Asia into what is now Vietnam, and managed to establish official relationships between both empires, but further study from historians raises some doubts on if this event really happened, seeing that there's little to no evidence. It is thought instead that these men were just merchants disguising as Romans to try and scam the dynasty, but then again, this is just speculation. The only well-known and agreed Roman traveler to have visited the easternmost fringes of Central Asia was none other than Maestitianus, a resident of Trajan in the early 2nd century AD. Maes was an ancient Roman traveler of Macedonian culture, who came from a family of merchants who had both Syrian and Roman identity. He could speak Greek and had experience in traveling, so he was sent with an expedition that is recorded as having traveled the farthest along the Silk Road from the Mediterranean world. During a pause in the intermittent Roman struggles with Parthia, his party reached the famous stone tower around the Pamir Mountains close to the border with China. Almost nothing is known of him, apart from a brief credit in Ptolemy's geography, whose knowledge of Maes was gained through an intermediary source, Marinus of Tyre. When Maes' expedition reached the Pamirs, the Chinese general Ban Chao of the Han Empire intercepted the group and ensured they were taken eastward to the Chinese capital Luoyang. They were brought before the Han Emperor, and although the travelers spoke Greek and were with Parthian merchants, they did not identify themselves as Romans. Thus, the Chinese did not realize they were dealing with subjects of that Qin, the Roman Empire. Chinese records state that the encounter took place in 100 AD. As was standard protocol, the Maya's merchants offered tribute to the emperor by giving renowned Syrian silks and imperial gold coins that bore the image of Emperor of Trajan. They were given Han silks as diplomatic gifts and then sent back on their way back to Syria. It would take them 12 months to return home, totaling 2 years for the whole round trip. When they returned, knowledge of their experience spread around the Roman world, and for the first time, Romans in Egypt and Syria knew of a superpower in the Far East that produced large quantities of silk and steel. Maestitianus wrote a full account of the journey taken by his merchants, but only a brief summary of his work survives in the writings of Claudius Ptolemy. However, a brief article by Max Carey, a professor of ancient history, teased apart some probabilities, notably that the purpose of the expedition was to organize the import of Chinese silk by controlling or eliminating some of the middlemen through whom trade goods were passed, among whom the least dependable were the Parthians, and that the stone tower was located in Xinjiang, the westernmost province over which the Chinese periodically attempted control. Nowadays, there are artifacts which were uncovered in multiple excavations, such as these jars which seem to depict Roman dancers performing to the Chinese emperor. This seemed to allude to the fact that there was some kind of contact between the Han Dynasty and the Roman Empire, but according to scholars, these are most likely just travelers, or even artists descended from places all over Europe that happened to perform in East Asia, not being affiliated with any Western Empire. Later on, the Roman Empire fell, and the Byzantine Empire was created. The frequency and documentation of contact between the two increased, but in nowhere in the records it is clear that the Chinese knew about all the Roman engineering feats such as the Colosseum and aqueducts. In a nutshell, they were just aware of multiple storage buildings, carrier stations, and that the Romans liked to beat drums and wave flags. As for the Romans, they only possessed a few reports from the merchants stating that the eastern people were harmless and just wanted to trade, not to be confused by the similar looking tribes in the region, which were known to be much more savage and would even eat human flesh. If you'd like to know about another amazing culture that would soon grow on the complete opposite side of the world, please check this video about the Aztec Empire and their beautiful capital. Hope you enjoyed this one.